Welcome to Total Body Tony. My name is Ginger. I'll be your instructor for the next 30 minutes. This class can be intense, but it is for every level. So you just have to go a little lighter, or you can do less reps. If we're doing like 25 squats, you can do 10 or 15. Or you can do partials. So whatever we are doing, modify, planks. You can be on your knees instead of straight on plank. So this class can be for every level. So I will help you through that too as well, how to modify. And go ahead and get prepared, grab yourself some weights. Hopefully you have maybe a couple varieties of sizes so you can use maybe heavier for some of the larger muscles and then lighter for maybe like shoulders, they burn a little bit quicker. And if you don't have any weights, that's okay too. You can use your own body weight, or you can just grab some heavy water bottles or some heavy cans of food, whatever you have around the house, go ahead and grab it, get it ready. Grab a chair, make sure your chair is really sturdy. You don't want it to tip easy. And then also a mat or a towel. That's all you need. So go ahead and gather those things and let's get started. We're just gonna do a brief little warm up. You're gonna just start marching in place. Start getting the body warmed up, blood flowing. And a lot of the exercises that we continue to do will be still kind of warming up while you're actually working as well. So the warm up won't be too long. Open up the march, just a little wider, but keep those knees lifting. Let your arms go naturally. A couple more, and then toe tap. You're just gonna tap, loosen up the hip. Make sure your feet, knees, and ankles are just all loose. Kind of turn with your hip. And then do a little rotation through the center. Reach across. And you're gonna take the elbow, reach and reach. Get a little bit more shoulders in there. Upper back. And then you're gonna reach up. So reach, reach. And just tap, and then take that toe up. Really get the toe up there so you feel like it's going up the calf and then through the backside. And right into leg curls, heel to the bottom, pull it back. Make sure your knees are soft. Don't land with locked kneecaps. Really hard on your knees. Pull it back. Just start feeling that blood flowing. And then lift the knees right here, just lift, nice and tall, abs are in. Three more, two more, and march it out. Okay, you should feel that blood flowing, feel a little bit warmed up. We're gonna go ahead and go into partial squats, legs hip width. Make sure your bottom goes back. You don't want your knees to go forward. So like you're gonna sit back in your chair. Squeeze up through the glutes when you come up. So you're pushing through the heels, through the floor, and come up and then squeeze. Now again, if you're just starting out and not very advanced, you can just do partials. Everything we do, you can do partials. And also less reps. Anytime you get really tired, please don't stop completely still, especially if your heart rate's up. You want to still keep something moving. So it could be just stepping side to side or marching in place. Tell you, catch your breath again and then come right back and do what we're doing. Okay, a couple more. Last one. And shake it out. Okay, we're going to continue with the squat. We're going to add a reverse lunge. Make sure your lunge, you don't step too close to your body. So when you drop your knee, your legs are shoved forward. You want to make sure you step back far enough where this knee drops and this knee is not way over that toe. So you're going to feel a little bit less stable, but that's a good thing because then your stabilizers kick in. So make sure you step back far enough. Don't stretch, but drop the knee so you go into a lunge. That means that heel has to come up. So we're going to do a combination to your right. You're going to be doing a squat, try to balance. If you have to tap, that's okay. But we're gonna try to balance from that squat and go into a reverse lunge. So those two combinations together. So we're gonna squat, balance, lunge back, balance. And again, if you can't balance, just tap the floor. Focus on your forearm, bottom back, long stride, drop that knee. Okay, five more. Four. Three. Two. And one. See what I was saying? Your heart rate goes up, so you're still warming up at the same time. Okay, to your left. Squat, balance if you can. Lunge way back, drop that knee. Bottom back, balance. Tap if you need to. Five more sets now. Almost there. Three. One more. Lunge back. And shake it out. Good job. Okay, let's grab some dumbbells. Grab some light ones. We're gonna incorporate some shoulders with squats. So you're gonna do your basic squat, and when we come up from the squat, don't lock your knees. Make sure when you come up, you still have soft knees, abs are in, and then you're gonna do a lateral raise. So they're just resting when you squat, sit your butt back, soft knees when you come up, lateral. Shoulders burn. Make sure you don't go too high. Just as high as your shoulders. Bottom goes back. Push through those heels. Squeeze your butt as you come up. Don't walk the kneecaps. If it gets to where the shoulders are burning too much, can't do any more reps, just continue the squats. Five more. Four. Three. Last one. Woo! Feel that, shake it out. Okay, we're gonna do shoulder presses, but we're gonna stay in a position with our legs, so your legs are gonna burn without moving them while you're doing the shoulder press. You're gonna step back in that lunge. Remember, the leg isn't straight. This is a stretch. This is a lunge. Drop the back knee. Bring those dumbbells alongside. Make sure they're not resting on you. Press up for 10. Make sure that back knee's low. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight, should be burning. Nine. 10. Release. Ooh, shake it out. You should feel those legs burning. Other side, take it back. Drop that back knee. Make sure it's nice and low, nice and tall. Ready? 10 presses. 10. Two more. Shake it out. Ooh. Okay, grab your light dumbbell. We're going to use a chair. Don't forget to hydrate throughout the class. Now, this is optional if you want to use a dumbbell. You can use your water bottle. It's still some resistance, but not so intense. These are difficult without anything, you're just using your own body. So if you are advanced, grab a dumbbell. If you're not very advanced, you're just starting out, or you haven't worked out in a long time, you might want to just do these without. So we're going to have our legs up, and we're going to concentrate on the quad. You're going to get a lot of core muscles, a lot of stomach, and you're just going to flex straight. Make sure you focus here. Those muscles are going to flex. So I'm going to grab the dumbbell, lean back, try not to rest on your chair. Hang on if you need to. You just pick it up, keep your feet closed, your shoes closed, and they will not fall out as long as your shoes are together. And you're going to flex. 10. We're going to do 3 sets. Squeeze. Flex those quads. 2 more. 1 more. And release. You're feeling it right there, and also your stomach. Second set. Now you can always, if this was too much, drop it. Okay, bring it up. Pull those knees up and just straighten out. Don't lower your knees. You're just, it's like a hinge from the knee down to the feet. One more. And rest it. One more time. Get rid of your dumbbell if you need to. For those that are advanced, if you want to go heavier, grab your heavier one. It's your last one. Last set of 10. Knees up. Flex. Feel those quads working. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, and rest it. Whew. A lot of you might be feeling too, your hips, your inner thighs, outer thighs, all around the hip area, depending on what you've been doing or if they're a little bit on the weak side. Okay, we're gonna go to bicep curls. So pick your dumbbells accordingly. We're gonna use one dumbbell to start out. We're gonna do one arm first. So stay light if you are just coming back or you're just starting out. So we're going to hold it right on our hip. Make sure it doesn't float around, move around. It's going to just stay on the hip and be supported. Watch your wrists. It's very common, especially women, to let their wrists torque back like this. Flex it. Cup it. Keep it cupped, especially when you go down. Don't let it fall back. Keep that control. Stay away from your shoulder 4 or 5 inches. So you're going to curl, hold it, keep that wrist cupped, hold it away from your shoulder and back down. We're going to do a set of 15. Checking your wrists, especially when you're down at the extension. So we tend to kind of torque it back. 2 more. And switch sides. Rest it on that hip. Turn that wrist. Cup it. And then curl. Watch that space. Don't come right into your shoulder. That's a rest area. And then you don't have that contraction anymore. knees. Feel that bicep. You don't want to rest down here, you don't want to rest up here. Five more. Really keeping that contraction, getting the most out of it. Two more. And release it. Okay, we're gonna finish off those biceps. I'm gonna grab another dumbbell. You might wanna go lighter. Grab two. We're gonna do half circles. You wanna keep them really close to your chest. You don't want them out here. Soft knees, you're gonna bring them in. Half circle, squeeze. It kinda comes outside of your shoulders just a little bit, but be careful. You don't let the weight pull you and let it fall out this way and pull on your elbow joint. So you're controlling it. Up, half circle, squeeze out. Hold the control right here, don't let it swing. Down here is real common to just swing. Don't do that. Squeeze on the outside, hold control, squeeze. So you're getting both directions, controlling both directions. Side view, look how close I am to my body. Don't lock your kneecaps. Half circle, squeeze. Really close to your body. Almost there, we're doing 15 of these as well. Squeeze, don't rest at the bottom, don't rest at the top. We got one more. That's it, good job guys. Triceps, back of the arm. It's a little harder for most people than by, so you might want to go lighter. Again, it's up to you. We're going to just stand. Put that arm next to the ear. You can even grab it, make sure it stays there. And instead of going across and up behind your head, I'm going to let you just let it fall naturally. Everybody's different, depending on their shoulder, where it falls. But everybody needs to keep their arm next to the ear. This applies to everybody. Don't let your arm float around. So you keep it next to the ear, and you're just gonna let it fall back behind you, not too far back, and squeeze. So it goes parallel to the floor, and squeeze. So some people are directly behind them. Some people are more at an angle. Everybody's a little different. So we're going to do 15 of these. Make sure you go all the way up, flex. You have to straighten out in order to flex that tricep. Remember your knees, don't lock them. Squeeze, don't rest it at the bottom, don't rest it at the top. Five more, and four, three, two, and one. And switch. So remember, you get to just let it fall back naturally where it wants to go for you. But keep your arm from floating. Soft knees. Here we go. Drop it and squeeze. Drop it and squeeze. Make sure that that dumbbell doesn't go too far back. Pulling on your elbow. Don't rest it at the top. Don't rest it at the bottom. But make sure you flex. I want you to feel that back of that arm working. Flex. Five more. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. And bring it down. Okay, this one's a little more challenging. You can modify it by not even doing the tilt with the legs up. We're gonna do our triceps again. We're gonna use both arms, but we're gonna add to it to make it a little tougher. You're gonna lean back, but don't rest on your chair. Legs up, so you're in, really targeting your stomach. Bring that up, it's gonna change, so a couple reps, you might have to find your center. It might make you feel like you're gonna fall back, so you gotta find your center. So legs up, you're gonna bend and straighten. Bend. And straighten. Again, remember, don't go too far back behind your head. This is kind of parallel to the floor, and you should go with it. Your stomach muscles really kicked in. Squeeze. squeeze at the top, don't rest, right back up, squeeze. We're doing 15. A lot of balance, so your core muscles are really engaged. Five more. Five, four, three, two, one, and release it. You should be feeling it all through the midsection as well. Okay, we're gonna go to our back, so get your heaviest ones that you have. Unless you are starting out, you haven't done anything for a while, you wanna go light. So you're gonna stick your bottom back, make sure you don't round over. Stick your bottom back. We're gonna do 3 sets of 10. Hang, pull right into the rib cage. Hold, pull right into the rib cage. 3, 4, make sure you're down low. 5, 6, 7. Abs in. One more. And rest it. We got 2 more like that. Remember, you're not rounding over. That stretches your back. And also, a lot of people, because it hurts your legs, you're in a squat and it's burning, they tend to come up a little bit more because it's a little easier. But when you come up, you're doing more shoulders. You're not against gravity so much for your back. You're going up, so you're hitting more of your shoulders. So you really do want to get down, stick your butt out, arch or have it flat, and pull right into the rib cage. Abs in. Come on. Those legs are burning, I know, but focus on your back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release it. Whew. One more time. Bottom back, get down low. Here we go, last 10. Two more. Pull, 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 and one. Woo! Okay, grab your light one. We're still gonna target back. It's gonna be the upper back, and we're going out away from our body. So further you are away from your body, the harder it is, because your weight's way up here. So typically you have to go lighter, but those of you that are advanced, you know what to do. You can grab a heavier one, go for it. You're gonna use the chair, just for some balance. Same hand, same side leg, rest your body weight. And you wanna make sure, since we're working up here, that you line your arm up with that spot. If you pull back here, you're not targeting here. So wherever your arm is, it's targeting that area that's lined up with. So make sure it's like a big butterfly wing. Don't lock your joint. Don't have it too bent either. And sometimes I see this where they start like this and go like that. It is like a big butterfly wing. It stays the same whether it's here or all the way extended as far as the softness in the elbow. So you're gonna pull up, feel the upper back. Don't rest it here, pull up. We're gonna do a set of 10. You should feel that upper back or the rear shoulder. If you don't, adjust it. You need to adjust your arm to line it up with it. These are hard to do. Two more. And last. Now we're gonna switch. Same leg. Same arm. Remember, don't rest in here. Keep that contraction, soft elbow. Pull right alongside the upper back. So it supports your back when you lean forward. If they're too close, there's nothing to support your back. So feet out here, abs in. You're gonna target the same area, so line it up, line those arms up with the upper back. Here we go, last 10. Don't rest down here. Feel that burn, the back, upper back, rear shoulders. Two more. Last one. Okay, front shoulders. We're gonna do them together. Frontal raises, so choose how heavy you wanna go. We're gonna hold one, so you might want a heavier one. Three sets of 10. Soft knees, lift it no higher than your shoulders. Don't rest it down here, right back up. Your arms are straight, but they're not locked. Lots to think about. Soft knees, abs in. Straight arms, but not locked. You got this. Short rest, you got three sets. Short rest. Soft knees, here we go. 10, don't rest it down here. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, release. Last set, here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, and one, should be burning. Okay, grab your mat. I'm gonna hydrate. I'm gonna go ahead and lay all the way on your back. Bend your knees. We're gonna go full range. You can even hang on to a dumbbell or a ball to add some resistance. So you're gonna go behind your head, sit up. Behind your head, sit up. And again, you can grab a ball, water bottle, anything that gives you a little resistance, or just do it without. I'm not going to have a rest in between the next two. And go right into the next two exercises. Last one. Relax your neck and shoulders, bring those legs up, lift, and open and close, keep your butt lifted. You're going to keep opening and closing, but when you open, you're going to crunch. You're going to open and crunch, open and crunch. No rest. Really work your abs straightly, but there's not a whole lot of exercise. You only have one more, so hang in there. Take a breather if you need to, come right back. Okay, hold those legs together and pulse. Keep those shoulders up high, watch your chin, don't push it forward. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release it. Good job, guys.